staying double duelist on their entire map pool, but they strayed away from it here. And they're getting mega aggressive, though. Oh my goodness!
And they've used ult darts you saw from Ethias. Looked like they were darn close to possibly even connecting. No damage confirmed. There's a 0 point. B1 trying to come back through the elbow, but BCJ denies the first. Zelsus thinks about it, but then thinks better of it. And second around the back, good for two. Nobody scouted him out whatsoever. Now the jumping right clicks, no need. It'll be used to clear. Second gonna realize that it's time to go paint shells. And he's, as he does, gets caught as Penny, an aggressive peek, finds one, an opportunity for the second, but second's paint shells able to at least capitalize on his own trade. Now Effie's in the corner, able to get the second as well as the first that came through. Not gonna be able to get the third in lock, so Aaron keeps the play alive, but with 15 seconds, he gotta make a move, and Odorous will deny that from happening. Now it's just down to death. 1v3 now made a 1v2. Zelsus just playing the clock, and yeah, you see it on the minimap. Whippy's just running away. There will not be a clutch here, and D1 will get on the board.
They will. Exodus got help.
My situation is BCJ with that Aldrin has earned himself a Hunter's Fury, so there is possibility to open things up with it, and that's going to be indeed the call. Whippy staying safe behind his own poison cloud, but oh, it's actually going to be BCJ who finds the first kill. Zelsus now has to respond defensively with Whippy. They're good for one apiece. Zelsus takes the second, and then death long range. Not bad to find one with the Marshall, but really incompetent to try to stick for the plan. B1 positioning, but not quite yet contesting. Viper's picking to come out for the offense. A little bit of extra time now given for XX to set up the post plant that they want as version 1 has to back up. You see Aaron's position inside the cubby. He would be likely one of the first ones to actually find good true point of contact, but second spam takes down Odorous. Now numbers, but it's going to be the Hunter's Fury defensively coming through. Showstopper was earned and immediately pulled out, but no kills to tally. It's all XX so far. 5v3 situation, pure down to tragic health, but even critically, he's
stressed out in chaotic situations like that. I mean, think about, they got this out, this guiding light and grab. Well, we'll put Penny in a bad place. Great shock dart bounced in there as well. They're still trying to hold their ground, but now they overstayed the welcome. Big entry from BCJ.
Oh, but Penny does at least tally one before backing out. That's going
to
be Matt.
Much in the bag, and you have to wonder if Zelsus and Penny just want to try to hold on to weapons as best they can, just considering how low they're.
Maybe that position was one of the reasons why XZ wanted to maybe get a little bit more feist for it to be Zelsus tossing out whatever utility he possibly can while being vacuumed into this gravity well. Effies will fall from first blood as the cosmic divide separates this site into two. Another guiding light comes up, and Zelsus stays safe from it. Gets the first elimination. Now the flash through. Not going to bother trying to re-peek with this on the other side. That was BCJ. But then Zelsus wants to try to go maybe just to find an off angle, but not going to be allowed to. Pure able to capitalize on the punishment, and then Whippy left by their lonesome inside the site. Can't do much of anything but watch the spike get planted. Penny's going to try to go for an early contest, gets the first, but would be hard-pressed, you would think, to find more unless maybe some of the utility can connect. And honestly, the paint shells does find a big chunk of damage onto BCJ, but in a 3v1, XZ can just soak up the clock.
Yeah, they have great positioning. They're not going to get this guy too many 1v1s. They peek together off that dotting light.
And Penny, even though he does as a sheriff, does potentially have a showstopper, but the paint shells get the first one down. BCJ responds. There's the showstopper. Penny throws it out a little bit deep. Not going to be able to fully connect for too much of anything. Trusts the pistol now. Finds the first two. That's three in a row for him. Earns the paint shells back. The blast pack over the top. Can it bounce BCJ off the plant? No. So the spike goes down. We're still in a 2v2. And Zelsus on the backside gets a flash off onto BCJ. Just down to Pure. 1v2, stuck in a corner. Finds the first, good damage. Penny, quick to come through. There's the flashback over the corner. It's actually Fragment that comes through, and Zelsus will find it. Tally up a pistol eco for trading haymakers. Pure gonna be able to allow Zekin again to get through freely, and how about BCJ? He's able to connect once onto Effie's dancing. Is Effie's to try to get away, but BCJ tracks.
Team play of XZ coming through.
Whippy does get flushed out from the cubby, but gets away, finds one elimination, knows that there's a second. Odorous there to capitalize on the damage to credit the assist, but there is the rotation through the teleporter. There is no defenders here for B1. Quickly trying to get there is going to be Odorous, but this is a 3v2 that XZ have a huge advantage on, especially with the Viper's Pit.
Yeah, the Viper's Pit just kind of the chef's kiss at the end of it all. They'll be able to get in here with plenty of cover now. It's just going to be Odorous and Whippy having to try to go out there swinging with rifles. No utility left except for Whippy. Has one grab well, I believe, and one smoke.
One enemy remaining.
It will be all for naught, it seems. Devin BCJ will finish the job. Six here. Can it be stopped? Seekers go forward.
Think about this. Can Zelsus pop a very well-timed null command? Maybe to stop a showstopper. There it comes. Second, already through hookah. Seekers are going to be able to tag onto Effie's by the look of it. V1 has given this completely up. But the rocket comes out, and Zekin is going to realize that he's missed his opportunity. And actually, the null command was there to silence him completely. And Penny will find one trade back kill. 4v4 we go. Spike down. And in the backside of this play for the post plant for Xset are both Aaron and BCJ. But from the front, version one, started to overwhelm with numbers. Deck, three players in front of him, gets only one. BCJ holding on to a shock dart for a 3v2. No snake bites available for Aaron. You have to find kills if you're Xset. There's the first toggle. Oh, and the shock dart comes through, but it's not in a very good position. You have to check this. Petty finds one, earns the showstopper. Nail meets the coffin. Try to slow down this hit, wait for defensive rotations to get here. Zekid in the corner. Fragment gonna push him over a little bit, even closer, but still finds the first blood on the Zelsus. Etni's not swayed yet, tries to go for a plant. But just as the action unfolds and the retake is underway, they're forced to have to respond. Whippy late into the party. Odor is going to be affected by the Trailblazer, and now it's just down to Whippy. This would be a 1v4. A couple of low lines drawn in the sand as Penny gets the spike blinded. Defensively, two players to the teleporter. They want to try to contest Hookah. Odorous is currently here. And does look like he will drop a snake bite just to delay this inevitable hit that comes from behind. Seconds Blast Pack does connect to the Penny, but doesn't push him out from behind cover. And Odorous will secure a kill out of here. Aaron trying to get this Hookah position rather back into his favor and is able to do it. Now it's down to, can he get the weapon upgrade? Sure does. A couple of spam shots actually do tag, but time is running low here. It's a 3v3. Version 1 have abbreviated health both, but most of their positions still stay concealed. Penny for 2 and Death. 1v2 situation, and we'll say it 1v3 because he's also got to play up against the spike, and there will not be enough time for him to go for this. Effie's recognizes it, just runs away.
Yeah, I really feel like the heavy V split again, wanting to keep that fast-paced play that V1's used to.
Oh, so good. And there's a 0 point pure clean headshot, takes the lid right off of Penny, and that elimination is enough for version one to say, oh, okay, never mind. Let's head our way back over towards the A site. Aaron gonna read that the playthrough teleporter is starting to head over towards bathrooms, but maybe gets a bit too aggressive and falls to Whippy. BCJ was trying to throw a little bit of utility to slow down this hit, and now he's kind of caught by himself. Def is playing up top, and as BCJ makes sure that U-Haul stays safe, numbers will sustain for the defense, but Effie's needing to plant. 12 seconds on the clock. Zelsa is not able to keep him safe initially. The trade will be there, but knocked as the Null's command will essentially be, well, nulled.
Little distance yet. Pure is here. Owl coming through. Wow. What a pickup from BCJ off that Godding Light. Now they get the confirmation it's a B-split, and they have the opening blow in their favor.
And that's the 0 point gone as well. So Xset are going to back away from this. Penny still playing through Hookah, and Embiid is going to try to force some movement with the Hunter's Fury. BCJ has stayed alive and stayed completely concealed through this. Finds the second elimination for him. Then the third, pure on the opposite angle, will tally up a fourth. That Embiid, who's already committed into the site, has to try to make a play.
Can't work from Xset. Great team play defensively on that B side. Getting the Owl Drone out. Hookah detecting both players there. Guiding Light peek on to Long to not only get the confirmation, yeah, this is a B split being set up, but also being able to
maybe catch Xset off guard, but the Seekers will be there to respond defensively. So are the Hunters. Now there's the Hunters here. I was going to say the Aldrin was a part of that first, but BCJ able to find another first blood in the mix. Second gets involved for now, making it a 4v3. Defensively, big favor coming through, but Effie's finds one. If you can find a second, that'd be unbelievable, but it's trades back and forth, leaving Odorous in a 1v2. And Zekin will just make sure that there is nothing for this A site. Recon Bolt back right corner. Viper Wall to kind of split things off. Spam shots for Xset. And oh my goodness, Chaos has already started to unfold. Zelsus looking for the first one, finds it. But Zekin up top, trading things back. Able to at least find at least a chance to contest this initial plan as the spike will be dropped. Quickly collected as version one wants to try to get this play off.
They're going
to
play from long B post plant. No one has gotten forward towards defensive spawn. They're all playing from back here, basically. Xset don't know that yet, but it is going to make it tough to hold here for Yellow.
The late Aldrin was still being held onto. There is no more utility for Xset to play off, so Zekin has to essentially do it himself. Finds the first. Pure still working with Defra on the backside corner. Good damage comes through, and Pure is able to line up two quick taps for headshots. And Xset, they do respond again nicely to version 1's antics early in the pistol to take the first round.
And that's big for Xset, a team that at times has struggled on the attacking side of Icebox.
Play style. They will not really make the second step unless they find first blood. A lot of that was isolated by Penny last time around. As the raises will get involved early, Zelsus in second, trading to get things to a 4v4. Odorous thought about a plant, but as you see, the Sage Wall is completely dismantled. It's going to have to be more eliminations before you feel the safety blanket of trying to plant. And even though they do find another elimination, look at the flank of the minimap.
Yep.
It's going to be Pure on the long side. Whippy's looking for this, but has he maybe missed the timing? Maybe not. Pure's able to find one, but the trade will be there. Spike has been dropped. And is Penny, who has collected this, trying to make a play with it, toggles the sound cue, gets the bolt, the final two Xset members in version one. They get themselves on the
relentless with these attempts at these aggressive A attacks, just putting that Viper utility down, storming it with grenades, and just trying to get that space on site. Zelsus does indeed draw the first blood. Zekin stuck on an island, but comes out swinging for one himself here. Also able to chime in, but that's a big kill from Zelsus to at least keep it even.
But is there enough safety to get this plant off? Odorous seems to think yes, as the barrier orb will go down first, then the spike to follow, but Beer up top, aggressive with the angle, takes the pick before the exit could occur. So now 3v2, defensive numbers for Exet, but Zelsus from the high ground gets at least some tracers on where Aaron is positioned, and Whippy watching his back takes down that. There's the second elimination, three now for Zelsus. It's all down to Pier, who has fully committed with the operator just a bit wide, and Whippy
is going to take the blades mid-map.
Penny, first blood. Again, the aggression that's coming through, but Aaron wants to try to match that. Finds the first blood plus the boom bot and gets away without taking any damage. Pure R on the rotation.
Able to get- has been deployed by Screams. They're going to try to plant through it anyway.
Spike does get planted. Again, gatekeeping the exit currently is death. But second from the front finds one. Sound cue here, dab. Catches Whippy with a knife out. That's two straight kills. Penny now down to 61 HP, falls to the low.
So that's going to make things even lighter, but they will still take the site as Penny charges forward with the dash. Boombot comes out. He has to pull the pistol out, and he doesn't even fully take it before tanking some more.
And here's Exet defensively, using that as an opportunity to retake, really before the spike has even a chance at being planted. 13 seconds on the clock. Odor is still hanging on to the spike, but Death finds the elimination. Whippy, last one left alive, and oh man. An expensive round for Zekin's also playing backside at yellow. Maybe no opportunity here for Pure. This is the first, but that's on the second. What a nice little cheeky poke and play kind of setup. Effie's going to commit the Hunter's Fury, but once again, like you had mentioned from the A defense, Exet have gotten the first pick and backed away, giving Pure a second chance, but whiffs on it, and with that, Penny capitalizes with a double.
Yeah, that's a big double kill from Penny to help them along, get them some side control that evens the man count back out as well. And they don't necessarily have to commit to this, but the spike is going back by itself, and Aaron could cut it off. This could be such a huge one versus one if Zelsus slides out a bit too much and Aaron's able to catch him, and indeed he does have spike down. Doesn't get the second, though, so spike will get recollected. We got a 2-on-2, but Effie's only has 10 HP. Def will be able to kind of just stay back here.
He's seen a lot, but he takes a bit of damage. Effie's going to commit for the plant. Snakebite will not get there in time. Penny going to hold the high ground. On the rotation comes BCJ and finds Penny. So now it's down to Effie's in his barely double-digit HP. Oh, but he gets one with the shock dart. So now a 1v1. He knows where BCJ is likely going to be coming from, but does he predict low or does he predict high? Point of contact coming through. Does he hold the angle? Commits to it, but BCJ just too healthy. Avoids the potential headshot with that Exet. Get the defuse no problem for their sixth round.
Pretty scary round. Pure will get the new angle on Screen's position to handle this.
The Showstopper did come out, though, for Exet. It did not fully connect from Zekin. So the rotation to B is successful, even though Zelsus was lost in transition. So now the question becomes, Exet, how do you retake? Especially as it gets down to a 4v4. You're all over the map at the moment. And that could provide for a lot of 1v1s. And that is indeed what's happening until Penny cleans up the kitchen. It's good for three. Whippy down low. Next point of contact with second. Gets the first shot, no problem there. And it's all onto the player that initially was trying to play off the flank for a 1v3. Finds the first. 31 HP though, and it looks like Gabriel will likely concede.
Again, Penny coming up big in such a heated moment, you know. Aaron's flank able to find a pick. BCJ gets a lot of free damage through middle. Gets a good maneuver through kitchen to set up for the B play, but then Penny strikes Skull.
The thing about it that's different this time is that Pure has not vacated the site. He's going to stick around and maybe a little bit greedy, but it pays off. And behind that, the defensive pressure from BCJ's Hunter's Fury tags up a couple. Now the res will be through, so Penny rejoins the fight. Odorous backed off as the Boombot will deny the plant right over the barrier. Urban Zekin will get involved and make sure that Zelsus will for sure stay down. Pure still hanging out on the top ropes
to get ready for this plant. And oh, Aaron tries to pull one over there. Doesn't get it done though, so Spike will go down. And that's one player gain back for B1, but it's quickly stripped right back away.
I was about to say, if Effie's could find an elimination, he would earn a Hunter's Fury and maybe a chance to clutch the round off of that alone, but that is now off the table. The last two remaining V1 players cinematically hold the backside of yellow and the top side of green. Exet, quick to come through. Death gonna toggle. Whippy has to check this, but Odorous does actually find the first kill. Have they fully cleared? DCJ with the operator in hand, takes down Whippy and then Pure.
Then the way they layered their utility to push the players off site.
Penny getting aggressive. Recon Bolt has located him. And Def will say, hey, how you doing? Aaron as well, involved. Then why not for a second? Effie's, it's not bad. Zelsa's found a double before that Harness Fury came out, and oh my goodness, right here. Pure over the top, quite literally nearly Goomba stops Zelsa's, but Zekid makes sure that that goes through a little more cleanly than it was looking on screen. Leaving Effie's now in a 1v2, has the tally where the last two players are, finds the first, but caught during the reload, gets away from it, hello?
What?
Now a 1v1. Pure, though, will not be found out by the Recon Bolt, and it's a... Some decent sound cues here from Penny, and look at the playthrough mid-map for version 1. Huge first blood for Penny, sees a second, very wisely just dashes away. Exet, not committing as of yet, has a sentry turret to watch this flank, and it's gonna find some value. What the right click is that from Effie's? I think two of the three bullets get headshots. It leaves BCJ on a single point of health. And as Penny finds a second kill, here comes the flank, but it's actually Exet who battled back for three straight kills. And BCJ, he only needs one HP, apparently. Could he potentially still find the 1v1? Gets the Hunters, the dart, at least the tag. And an opportunity, if he goes wide. Hold this back alley. Penny, though, under threat. Effie's holding his close corners. Good for one, but the trade will be there. So now it's down to Penny. Sees the high ground play from second. Tries to find a little bit of wall spam. And just barely backs away before being figured out from the low. Has to try to updraft and does not quite get up in time to avoid the majority of the shock dart. Odorous now the next one in. But the toxic screen conceals all of these post-plant Exet members. And Zekin's just dancing with them. Just playing with a little bit of time here. Any damage is good damage at the moment. There is no flank coming through. V1 is going to full send this from the front. And Whippy, now involved, gets one. Odorous for the second. And it's a 3v2. But Exet's defensive retake is looking pretty solid from the high ground. It's down to BCJ. 1v2. This time, more than one HP. And that might be more than enough. Penny gonna soak up a bit of damage from the snake bite and BCJ for three.
It's softened up and there's still not been a full commitment yet. But Exet, we can see they're looking for it, and there is the big kill from Zek, and Penny able to respond.
Bit of utility coming in, may give them the call. Good informational read from Penny, but cannot confirm the kill. So Effie dives right onto the Viper's pit. That'll shut down Death very quickly. Trade for Zekid, 30 seconds on the clock. Still rotating his Whippy. This is still a 3v2 on the site for Exet as they try to go for the plant. Aaron backs off of it, and as he does, Odorous gets involved. How about a second for him? No, it's Aaron from the high ground that gets not just one, but a second, leaving him a 1v1, and he gets the toe tags on the Penny.
Again, man, because when you watch this Viper's Pit go down, and you watch just in a snap, it gets canceled out. Such a brilliant play for V1 to hop in there and then take.
Version 1, you look across their purchases, and it's not great. And Petty actually gets tagged up by BCJ for a lot of respect to version 1 setup.
Again, that's the discipline of Exet. The protocols, the game planning. Just being such a well-rounded team tactically, and you can see it here. Effie's, he wants to risk it. Does he want to go for the peak and try to get the even out?
Honest Fury just a touch too late to stop the plant. Judge up close. Celsus thinks, maybe not. We go back to the pistol, and as he does, it's Pure with knives! Oh my goodness!